very eyes that you can do nothing at all about. I think that's affected all our drivers very personally.
Unemployed teenagers who start claiming benefits will be forced to carry out community work. Under Tory plans, anyone aged 18 to 21 who's not had a job or been at college for 6 months will need to do work experience.
Jack FM Sport.
Peter Stringer will leave Bath at the end of the season. The veteran rugby union scrum half joined the Premiership club just over 2 years ago.
Jack FM weather with stbrendansixform.com. Meet the course tutors at the information evening on March 26th.
Bright and sunny today with highs of 8 degrees. That's the latest. There's more news online at jackbristol.com.
Jack FM travel with the Mall at Cribbs Causeway. Bristol Fashion Week Spring Summer 15, March 25th to 29th.
M4 on the eastbound, heading past Junction 19. That's the M32. It's looking quite busy heading towards Bath at the moment. Roadworks causing hold-ups around York Road and Clarence Road this morning. Not as bad as it was this time yesterday morning, though. But the Wells Road is struggling down to the Three Lamps Junction. And there is quite a lot of traffic on Redcliffe Hill and Redcliffe Way as well. Cattle Market Road sluggish to that point. M32, a little bit busy from Junction 3. Keynsham Bypass busy heading towards Salford. And there's a bit of traffic on Pembroke Park Road to the double mini roundabouts. No longer than about 5 minutes, though. So not looking too bad at all this morning. If you do spot anything else, it's Bristol 9341767.
Pancake Day is flipping fun. Pancake Day is Stella. This day will be a yummy one,
because pancakes love Nutella.
Pancake Day is nearly here. Gather friends and family to enjoy some delicious pancakes on Tuesday the 17th of February. And don't forget, pancakes love Nutella.
Bristol, the birthplace of America, and home to Downsy, Alice and Simon at breakfast. Now, live from Studio One at County Gates in Ashton, another hour of That Morning Thing.
Hello.
Hello.
Your name, please.
James from Knoll.
Your occupation?
I work for BT.
And your specialist subject?
Forgetting names of airports, I think.
OK. You have 1 minute if you choose to continue on general knowledge. Yes or no?
Yes.
Hey! £550 now at risk. That is James from Knoll. He's playing Gone in 60 Seconds after David Bowie.
Under the moonlight, this serious moonlight,
good morning. My name is Michael James Ian Clayton Downs. I was born in the John Radcliffe Hospital on the 12th of May 1977 at 20 past one lunchtime. Just in time for a feed. 7:21, the sunrise. The sun set at 5:30. The high tide is at 10 minutes past 6 tonight.
Peter Purvis Advice Service. Listen close now, it's a gem. Peter Purvis Advice Service on Jack FM.
Hello, I'm Peter Purvis. Welcome to my advice service. So, here it is. This is how to behave like a rapper. Just say, know what I'm saying? At the end of every sentence, or word. Know what I'm saying? Word.
Peter Purvis Advice Service on Jack FM.
10 questions, 60 seconds, and a cash jackpot. This is Calling 60 Seconds with a new breed of Harley at Riders Bristol. More than just a bike.
That is my favourite bit of advice.
It's just because it's Peter Purvis saying it, you know? It's just ridiculous.
Know what I'm saying?
Word.
Oh, amazing.
Right, morning, Bowley.
Morning.
You all right?
Yes, very good. I'm just wondering, do you pay Viz royalties for those, or do you just borrow them?
What do you mean?
It's advice service.
What do you say? Yes? What are you saying?
It just seemed very familiar.
Familiar to what? Sorry?
People who've read Viz magazine.
No, never heard of it.
No?
Never heard of it before. No. Never heard of that. Or top trips. I don't know where you're talking. Never heard of that or, you know, anything like that. Say the same about any joke on our radio station and we will sue you, James. That's how that works. Good luck with that. £550, just a drop in the ocean. Ready to play?
Yeah.
Good man. Why would you come on and say that?
I know.
Why would you do that?
You're bringing out a special question.
There you go. So, just to give you an insight into what goes on, before we went on air, I said, James, I'm feeling a bit spiky today, just to warn you. And so what James does is go out of his way to antagonise us.
I just thought that was common knowledge.
Yeah.
Well, let's hope this knowledge required is common knowledge.
I don't feel awkward, by the way. I don't feel awkward at all at the moment. Which question set, please?
One.
Question set one. All right, 60 seconds to answer all the questions correctly. The first answer you give is the one we take, unless you say pass, in which case we return to that question for time allowed. 6 years safe, seven or more, and you're in the money as well. The quiz master decision is final. Do you accept the rules?
I do.
Good luck. All right, here we go. You're gone in 60 seconds. Starts now. How many sides does a cube have?
Six.
What letter is represented by three dots in Morse code?
O.
Who, in 1973, recorded the multi-platinum selling single Tubular Bells?
Mike Oldfield.
What stretch of water separates Anglesey from mainland Wales?
The Menai Straits.
In degrees, what do the angles in a triangle add up to?
180.
In which novel by Charles Dickens does the character Uriah Heep appear?
Pass.
Which vegetable is Sir Walter Raleigh often credited with bringing to Britain?
Potato.
On a standard dartboard, what two numbers are adjacent to the zero?
Pass.
In computing, sorry, it's adjacent to the 20.
One and five.
In computing, what does the acronym RAM represent?
Random access memory.
In the comic books and feature films, what is the real name of Spider-Man?
Peter Parker.
In which novel by Charles
David
Dickens?
David Copperfield.
David Copperfield, and that is it. Happy?
Yeah,
reasonably. Let me just adding that up. Which was the... Oh, that one. Yeah, okay. I make that a nine, so... Nine gives you another £100, which gives you £650.
Okay.
You were so close with the dots in Morse code. It's actually the S, not the O, three dots.
Yeah. Oh, well.
Okay.
Easy when you know the answer.
Yeah.
You'll find tomorrow's quiz questions, by the way, in Viz Comic, page 32 this month.
Anyway, there he goes on his very, very final go at God in 60 Seconds before we block his number. There's James from Norfolk.